Hey, I'm Not So Ace Trainer, and here's some still unconfirmed Pokémon that we could see in Pokémon Legends Arceus. Let's get into it. In order to theorize what Pokémon we could see in Pokémon Legends Arceus, we have to take a look at Pokémon geography. While there is no confirmed multi-region map of the Pokémon world, there are some games which gives us hints or just simply show us where a region is located in relation to another one. The best example of these are Johto and Kanto. When we play through the Johto games, both in their original and their remake form, we learn that Kanto is located east of the Johto region. While there was never another instance where we could explore two regions in the same game, we had something close to that in HeartGold and SoulSilver. On those games, we could gain access to the Sinjo Ruins, a temple in honor of Arceus. It was built by people hailing from Sinnoh and Johto, bearing elements from the Spear Pillar and the Ruins Evolve. While we're in the Sinjo Ruins area, if we check our Pokégear, we can see that it pinpoints our character north of Blackthorn City and northeast of the Lake of Rage. Because of this, we can assume that Sinnoh is located somewhere north of Johto and northwest of Kanto. With this in mind, I assumed Pokémon found inside this circle to have a possibility to be found in the old Sinnoh territory. This includes Route 37, 38, 42, 43, 44 and Mount Silver. Another thing I did, since putting every single one of them would not be the best decision, I cross-referenced the spawns on those routes with the PokéRadar spawns from the original Sinnoh games. The PokéRadar allowed us to find species that are not native to the Sinnoh region and that were very scarce in the region at that time, which could mean that they are remnants of once larger populations. So, while these Pokémon are not new to the region, I believe they will be easier to find and in way bigger numbers in Pokémon Legends Arceus. With this out of the way, let's get into number 1. I'm starting this list with Stantler. Stantler is found through PokéRadar on Route 207 in Sinnoh and in Route 37 in Johto, just south of Ikrutik City. Considering that Sinnoh seems to be in such a wild state when we look at the trailers, we could assume the same for Johto. A still underdeveloped Ikrutik wouldn't be an obstacle for Stantler to migrate. Also, as I mentioned on a previous video, I believe that the riding Pokémon from the slideshow leaks could be Stantler, even a regional or ancient form of it. Maybe this Pokémon was native to the Sinnoh region, and ended up migrating towards Johto because of some change in its habitat, which led to it changing its form over time to adapt to its new home. Also, do you think we're getting ancient original forms in Pokémon Legends Arceus? Let me know in the comments down below. Let's get to number 2. At number 2, we have Marip and its evolutions Fluffy and Ampharos. These Pokémon can be found on Route 42 in Johto and were previously found in Valley Windworks in Sinnoh, using the PokéRadar. Since Valley Windworks is a power plant, it makes sense that these Pokémon were found there, with them being electric type. But what if they were found in way bigger numbers before? Maybe a rise in the population of Shinx, Luxio and Luxray in the general area of what today is Valley Windworks pushed this population further south, or simply highly decreased its numbers in Sinnoh due to predation. Let's get to number 3. At number 3, we have Mankey and Primeape. Mankey is found on Route 42 in the Johto region and, together with its evolution, is found on Route 225 and 226 in Sinnoh, using the PokéRadar. These are two Pokémon that I wouldn't be surprised get an ancient or regional form, especially Primeape. For some reason, Primeape has a modern thing to its design. I don't know, maybe it's the bracelets and anklets, but I believe that more fur and those removed would get him a pretty cool, wilder appearance. There isn't much to these ones besides the theory that their decrease in numbers and consequent migration is due to territorial disputes with the modern dominant fighting type on Route 225 and 226, Machoke. At number 4, we have two Pokémon that, while not part of the same evolutionary line, are connected in what their species represent. Both are found on Route 38 in Johto and in Route 209 and 210 in Sinnoh, only through the use of PokéRadar. I'm talking about Tauros and Miltank. These, much like Mankey, Primeape and Stantler, are great candidates for an ancient form since, although found in the wild, they were domesticated by humans through time. Wilder versions of this Pokémon would be an amazing sight to see running through the fields of old Sinnoh. At number 5, we have Larvitar and its evolutions, Pupitar and Tyranitar. Larvitar is found on Mount Silver in the Johto region and Route 207 in the Sinnoh region, using the PokéRadar, of course. While I do believe we'll see them in greater numbers than in the original Sinnoh games, I still think they will be rare to find. Not much here about how their population might have decreased or why they might have migrated, only a small theory that Mount Silver might be somehow physically connected to the same mountain range where Mount Coronet is. In the map, this mountain range seems to continue further south, where I'm assuming Johto is located. Route 207, where Larvitar is found, is one of the routes that has an entrance to Mount Coronet. The human population might just have pushed them further down the mountain range until they found their place in a much less populated area, Mount Silver. We're ending this list with what I feel is more like a spoiler than a prediction, though I think everyone was expecting this Pokémon to be part of the games. Unknown, the symbol Pokémon is somehow connected to Arceus, in a way that has yet to be explained. When we take Arceus to the Sinjar Ruins, as the original one is creating either a Palkia, a Dialga or a Giratina, unknowns surround him, seemingly attracted or connected to that power somehow. So it would not be a surprise at all to see this Pokémon in the game. Maybe even collecting each one would be a big part of finding Arceus. That was the end of the list. It wasn't about the coolest Pokémon, though I tried to choose some of the best entries that I could somehow explain. There are quite a few others that are found through PokéRadar and are native to either Johto or Kanto, like Nidoran and Sunkern. Though, we have a few from Owen, and that's the part that's making me scratch my head. I'm sure something will come up. I want to thank you all for watching and remind you to leave a like if you enjoyed the video and subscribe for more Pokémon content. Goodbye and see you all on the next one.